And this is the last bottle of waste oil. I'm collecting waste oil now since 1.5 years, and all these bottles are the result of only 2 weeks of cooking of my neighbors. We are going to convert together now this waste oil into biodiesel, and I can use this biodiesel to power my car and the engine of the car without problems. We've seen also last week how much energy there's inside a couple drops of this oil, which is very impressive, and we can use all this power to power the vehicle. So let's get started. We need only a couple chemical components, and yeah, but first, intro. This project we need for sure a huge container. I choose this because it's transparent. I'm talking about a kegs container. This is usually used to contain beer. We need to open a hole on the bottom, remove the inner bag, and here I have to glue in place a little valve. We can use a polyurethanic glue to do this. I suggest you don't use silicone because it doesn't stick very well to plastic. I can take a metal base and make sure that this is pretty sturdy because this later will be very heavy. I also mount a wood bar here on the left because later I will install some filters because this oil, as you can see, has a lot of dirt in the bottom. This is waste food. People use this oil to cook food, so I have to filter all these bottles. I'm talking about 20 liters of oil, and to do this I choose two filters with two different mesh. A bigger one that I have to filter only big parts, and a very small one. I'm talking about 10 or 30 micron. I can then screen place the filter here on the top and put both of them, one on top of another, and then I can pour the oil inside filters. This takes some time. I'm talking about 3 hours to filter 20 liters of oil. I also suggest you to wash or to replace filters after half an hour. Otherwise, all the little holes of the filter will get stuck and no more oil will pass through it. So this is the result. Let all the oil filter. Just take it time. And while I'm filtering all the oil, I'm just working on other projects, so this isn't difficult for me. After a couple hours, I remove the filters, and this is the result. 20 liters of pretty clean oil. So now it's time to take all the chemicals and transform this waste oil into functional biodiesel. The first one is methanol alcohol. We need to take 2 liters of it. And the next one is much more dangerous. I'm talking about sodium hydroxide. We absolutely need to wear a mask, gloves, and protect our eyes. Only one little drop can make our eyes become blind. This is sodium hydroxide. It looks like salt, and we need to take a very small amount. I put here a percentage so you know absolutely how to add perfect amount of it. So it's crucial here now to add sodium hydroxide to alcohol and not the opposite. Otherwise we will generate so much heat and it can explode, and it's very, very dangerous. So always remember, pour sodium hydroxide into alcohol. Now we may have to make sure that all the sodium hydroxide dissolve into the alcohol, and to make things faster, I'm using a drill with a stainless steel thing inside, and I can mix for about 1 or 2 minutes all the alcohol. We can see that the sodium hydroxide mix and dissolve into the liquid without problems. It's very important to use a container with this shape because all the drops doesn't go out very easy. So I'm checking that we don't have residue of sodium hydroxide, and now we can pour this inside the oil. We don't have to do it very fast. Take your time and pour a little bit of a time. And it's so nice to see how the oil change color as soon it touched the alcohol. It starts to become like milk. This is the first reaction we have to produce inside the oil. We need then to stir and to mix very well and keep in movement all this oil. I don't have time to stay here to mix it manually, so I decide to use compressed air. I connect a brass weight on a little plastic tube so that keeps the tube on the bottom of the container. I then can push air inside oil. So all these very big bubbles start to mix the oil and will move for 4 hours all this liquid. This is very important because we have to make sure that all the molecules of oil comes in touch with the molecules of the acid alcohol. So this is going pretty well, but I'm having a huge problem. I'm here in the shop, I don't know what's going on, but I leave it here for about 1 day and a half. You can see that the clock is turning, but almost nothing is happening inside the container. Doesn't seem so, but here in my shop it's so cold. Here is winter and the cold really slows down the reaction. So I need to warm up and to heat the oil. Let's see how. We need then to heat up the oil. You can buy and search online for heating element that heats up water and oil, but I just took apart this from a vacuum cleaner, a steam cleaner here in my shop. I can then power it with only 36 volts AC, so I don't risk to get electrocuted, and put it inside oil. You can see that it's producing so much heat that it is frying literally the oil inside. We need to make sure to reach the perfect temperature, and I can use this meter with a little controller here in the stainless steel handle, and I have to reach a temperature between 50 and 65 degrees because this makes the oil much more fluid and starts the reaction. After only 20 minutes we reach the perfect temperature, and you can see that we are having a glycerin and soap residue here on the bottom. This is what we are looking for. We have to split the components. We have to have biodiesel on the bottom and the top, and on the bottom all the waste materials. So let's wait some more time because I'm sure that this is the right way. If you remember, we also glue a little valve here on the bottom, and now it's so handy. I can take a glass container, put it here on the bottom, open the valve, and now the only part that is flowing through the valve is the glycerin residue that is on the bottom. So let's pour it all the way out. Everything is working, but as soon as we see the color changing, we need to close very rapidly the valve because this is biodiesel, it's very precious for us. Now the biodiesel seems ready, but there are for sure some residue. I'm talking about glycerin and also a little bit of soap inside the biodiesel. To make sure to remove all these components, we can do two things. We can wait some time so all the alcohol can dissolve and evaporate by itself, and so the glycerin and the soap will settle down on the bottom. Instead, we can speed up the process and blow some hot air inside the biodiesel. So we can create some hot air bubbles, and this hot air will speed up the evaporation of the alcohol. So as well, the glycerin and the soap will settle down on the bottom, and we can remove it using the little knob here on the bottom. In this case, I'm not in a hurry, so I decided to wait 4 days. Thank you.
I really suggest you, once you put biodiesel inside the car, to mix 50% of biodiesel we just made with 50% of regular biodiesel, regular diesel you can buy at the gas station. Because this is self-made biodiesel, we don't really have laboratory instruments to test the quality of it. So mix the two together gives a much more fluid biodiesel and diesel. Because the cold weather gets more thicker and the viscosity of the biodiesel. So mixing the two together is perfect and we can put it inside the car. So now I'm going to drop 15 liters of biodiesel and add 15 liters of regular diesel. At this point, let me tell you, take this video just as an experiment so you've learned something new today, but don't replicate what you've seen until now. I've used some very dangerous chemical reactions, and also you can risk to ruin the engine of your car. At this point, I leave you here my two previous projects, so this one and this one, check them out both, and see you next week in another do-it-yourself tutorial. Ciao.